Hello, everybody. This is Al Takatsch with Jefferson ClockWorks, and here is the completed spring winder. And of course, we have the ratchet assembly. This is the reversing knob.
Rig wheel with the loop end spring. Ratchet holds it, as you can see. Hold on to that handle really tight. Don't let it have a mind of its own. So it's on up. Now we undo the arbor. Alright, and now we're going to wind the spring up until it becomes smaller than a clamp and slide the clamp away. See the way I'm holding that hook? Clamp got a little wiggly, which means that it's loose, just like that. And now we want to reverse it. Mainspring is very important. Again, don't lubricate it until you get this thing in the barrel. It can actually be wound even more if it's necessary, but it's not. That spring clamp goes right over it, and then you would, leaving the mainspring alone, you would rotate this guy as much as you can that way, and that gives you more stick out. It needs to live. So, there we go, we pushed it in. Change the direction of the winder. Make sure we got a good hold on this guy, because when it snaps like that, it's going to want to turn in your hand. You see that thing kind of rotating? Here it comes. There it is. And it just got captured. That triangle caught that hole of the mainspring. Okay, and now we should be able to take out the mainspring clamp. We're holding the torque with our gloved hand. We change direction. And we release the mainspring into the barrel. Okay. Most clock oil in warranty work. And it's in there. No damage to it whatsoever. The plastic did not mar it. It's still being captured. There's no damage to the wheel teeth. I mean, where if you got a welder, why not make one?